Greetings Guardians, my name is Bife here. The faction rally began today. For those of you looking to join up, there's the three choices: the New Monarchy, the Future War Cult, and the Dead Orbit. I've already made lore videos on the Future War Cult and the New Monarchy, but now it's time to talk about our third and final faction, the Dead Orbit. They're looking to be the most popular faction thanks to that sweet scout rifle that they're selling, or maybe it's because the community is filled with edgelords, or maybe it's all the
nihilistic poetry and lots of pictures of people wearing black. Dead Orbit folks. About what you'd expect.
Okay, enough jokes. Whilst Dead Orbit does offer some good shaders, they are also a pretty divisive faction in their beliefs. We're going to go into all of that here, and now, bias aside, I'm going to talk about their philosophy and history. So where do we start? Well, we start in the collapse. The cataclysm that engulfed us was quite a traumatic experience for any individual, but on a societal level, it bred a fair deal of fatalism, this idea that everyone is doomed and we're all going to basically die. This started with a very simple idea. What chance do we have to stand against a darkness that decimated the Traveler? This alien miracle was just that, a miracle. The fact that we're still standing here is incredible, and we should get out before something like that ever happens again. Then, there were the many alien races that streamed towards the Traveler's remains, attempting to claim it and constantly attacking the city. They see the city as a trap. We are literally trapped here, and so we need to flee. All of this is led by an obsession, of course, therefore, with escaping our world. Many of Dead Orbit's Arachs believe that Earth is doomed and that we need to simply leave the Traveler behind. These people eventually formed from the early collapse days into a rather great collective that would eventually call itself the Dead Orbit. Now, let's be clear, there are three takes on this ideology of we need to get the hell out. The first is a less enlightened one, and that's that the Dead Orbit are nothing but cowards. There are those that would cling to this dogma and say that the Dead Orbit merely wish to flee and stand for nothing more than saving their own skins. But this is in itself not something the Dead Orbit would deny. They, however, instead of cowardice, call it realism, because perhaps it is. This is the second interpretation of their philosophy. In other words, yes, we're running, and if we don't, humanity will be driven to extinction. They believe that they need to spread humanity amongst the stars in order to ensure our continued survival as a species. And this really brings us to the third interpretation of Dead Orbit's philosophy. The interpretation that sees them as noble explorers chasing the unknown, reaching out into the dark void beyond the grasp of humanity, and finding our future greatness there in the stars. Whichever of these interpretations you prescribe to, these are some facts that you should know about the Dead Orbit. They maintain at this point the largest fleet of any faction within the FOTC, or the Forces of the City as it's otherwise known. Sometimes these are vessels built for a purpose. More often than not, however, these vessels are cobbled together into transports or defensive corvettes. Their fleet is, as you might call it, a bit ragtag. Dead Orbit also maintains a series of signal beacons throughout the system that allows them to pick up and intercept communications and frequencies from our enemies. These were vital in terms of their importance for intelligence when it came to our first warning that the Red Legion was on its way. This, of course, happened during the outbound signal mission in the Taken King expansion. The Dead Orbit's organization and leadership structure is split into a variety of leaders in charge of portions of the Dead Orbit fleet known as the Arachs. From passages I've read, from various armor pieces that I've seen, and from every indication, it would appear that every individual Arach commands a single ship and acts as sort of a joint captain and pathfinder. This isn't something that's really completely confirmed, but it seems all but confirmed. So for the moment, take that information with a pinch of salt. The Arachs of Dead Orbit have taken to Arach Jalal as a representative on the Consensus Council, an Awoken whose practical and utilitarian approach is fueled by the same nihilistic drive that fills many of the Arachs. He has, however, been known to bend and break rules occasionally in pursuit of Dead Orbit's great project to save humanity. And after all, why shouldn't he? When the goal is humanity's survival, one cannot let rules and regulations prevent you from acting. Rules are only as good as the principles that they uphold, and if the principles do not serve us and the rest of our civilization, then we should abandon them, and we should be harsh about how we abandon them. This brings about the nature of Dead Orbit as a faction in general. In a word, the organization is a clandestine one. They often go to extraordinary lengths to get what they need, and this includes putting their crews and fleet in intense danger where necessary. Such is the story of one dead orbit vessel called the Sophia. The Sophia's crew went deep into a woken space near the reef without the permission of the city. Of course, this was also something where they would never alert the tower on such a clandestine mission, because they would be denied. Places such as the reef are often only frequented by guardian craft, and at this exact moment in time when the Sophia entered, the ties to the reef and the city had not been properly formed. The crew found an abandoned space station that they would refer to as A113, but this would ultimately be their doom. By the way, look up A113. It's a little bit of an inside joke in the film world. The station, which was floating around the asteroid of Ceres, which, by the way, is right in the middle of the Awoken Reefborn's territory, was actually somewhere where there were Awoken ships around, and those ships opened fire and crippled the Sophia's engines. The crew, 6 days later, was forced to abandon ship for A113. They found a strange anomaly within that station that they referred to only as the keyholes. Upon entering such anomalies, the members of Sophia's crew were driven insane, and as a result, many of them died. The final log comes from the Arach of the crew, and ultimately it's kind of a tragic tale. He finds a nearly dead ghost, and has to simply say goodbye to it. He hasn't slept in 7.5 days. And yeah, it's kind of terrifying. Whilst we have no explanation of the nature of those keyholes that the crew of the Sophia found back on A113, or what their origin might be, there is something that should be stressed here. The Sophia's crew took a risk and accepted the consequences of their failure. There is a bit of honor and a lot of bravery in such action, even if they should have reported the incident to the Vanguard, and even if they should have told the tower. Yeah, there's bravery amongst the dead orbit, just all the same. It's a kind of rogue and strange bravery that maybe ends up with them being cowards and fleeing. Maybe this is similar to the path of the Fallen, which ultimately is part of the reason why I don't side with them. I believe the Fallen's corruption is partly because they fleed. However, you cannot doubt that some of their members are brave beyond comparison. In Destiny 2, Dead Orbit continues its practice of building a fleet to help us escape the doom of our planet, but there appears to be some form of interfaction rivalry at this moment. Someone is spying on Arach Jalal, as can be seen from this scannable in the tower hangar, which is on a beam directly above him. Check this out.
This is weird. Was someone spying on Arach Jalal? Some of the papers are signed Arach, but it's not Jalal's handwriting. I don't think I'll ever understand faction politics.
Could this lead to an impending revolt within one of the city's largest factions? Possibly, but for the moment, the Dead Orbit continue to be what they have always been. Pessimists, perhaps realists, and ultimately, the ones that might save humanity one day. Be sure to tell me what you think of Dead Orbit as a faction in the comments section down below, and if you're a supporter of Dead Orbit, then please let me know by leaving a like on this video. In addition, if you want more Destiny content, then you can expect more regular uploads from me. Simply hit the subscribe button, and of course, if you want email notifications so that you never miss my content, hit the bell next to subscribe. But of course, your viewership is quite enough for me. And in the meantime, my name is Bife. Per audacia ad astra. I'll see you, Starside.